Hi ladies, I'm here to do a quick tutorial on how I put this flower together. And this is the flower that I had on my altered organizer. And I told you this was one that I made to resemble the ones that Juliana makes. She always makes these awesome flowers and she puts like these little pearls and trims and all kinds of things hanging down from them. So she's where I got the idea from. And also I had a lot of just random scraps of lace that I needed to find a use for. So I used them to create this particular flower. And now of course I'm almost out of scraps, so I'm just using regular lace. But you can use regular lace that you have. And let me go ahead and go over what you're gonna need to make a flower like this. Now if you're gonna make it out of lace, it can really be any kind of lace. It can be lace that you purchased by the yard. You know, this is a thicker lace. This is probably about a 3-inch lace or so, maybe 3.5. And I have about 14 inches of it. And then this lace was just part of a long piece of lace fabric I had, and it's probably about 3.5 inches in width as well. And it's pretty long, but you're only gonna need about a foot of whatever lace you're using, probably anywhere between 12 and 14 inches. You could use a tulle or a fabric or any kind of netting that you have as well, and that would work for these. You're also going to need some pearl trim, and lastly you're going to need anything else that you want to hang down from the flower. I just have pieces of lace that I've cut off of a large piece of lace fabric, and I'm just going to hang those down. On my flower, on my organizer, I cut thin pieces of this. Really, you could use anything you wanted. Seam binding works well too. Seam binding would work really well hanging down from the flower. And oh, I lied, that's not the last thing. Okay, the last thing you're gonna need is if you wanna do something with the center, you can put anything in the center you want. I'm actually gonna kinda cut apart one of my shabby rosette flowers to put in there, and then just a pearl and rhinestone center is what I'm gonna have. So, all right, let me go ahead and get started. Now for this one, I'm just going to make a very similar flower to what I already made for the purpose of the tutorial. And you want to start by cutting the pieces that you need. So I'm going to cut just a square, and I do not measure, I just kind of eyeball it. If it's a little off, it doesn't matter. This is just about a 3.5 by 3.5 square. If you want a smaller flower, you could use smaller squares, and likewise a larger flower, larger squares. But I'm just going to cut 4 squares here. And let me show you how to put the flower together. So, for each piece, you're going to basically take your square, make it in frame here. Why am I not able to do this today? I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, guys. I keep moving, and I keep moving the wrong way, and I don't understand why. Okay, so anyway, you're going to fold it kind of catty corner, but you want to offset your point. So one point is going to be here and one point, or one corner is going to be here. You want to offset them. You don't want them lined up perfectly because that's just going to give it like that messy, shabby look. And if you put the corners together, it's just going to look too formed and too perfect. And then you fold it again. And I put a little dab of glue, hot glue, before I do that second fold. And then I just kind of hold it down. Be careful, it is hot, and because I'm using lace for this particular flower, it's going to kind of go right through the fabric. Okay. So that's how you form basically the pieces that are gonna make up one layer. So I'm gonna do the same thing, and let me show you on this white paper and see if maybe that's a little easier to see. Okay. Basically you wanna fold once so that the corners are kind of in the same area but not touching. You put a little dab of glue and then you're going to fold again, and you don't want the corners to be lined up perfectly. Okay, and that's how you basically form your, I guess, petals in this case. Okay, so let me zoom out just a little bit more because it's fuzzy there. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and repeat this, and now what you want to do is cut out just I'm using a old Prima package here, but you can just cut out any kind of cardstock or foam, square or circle, something that you can adhere your pieces to. And what I normally do is put a little bit of glue and adhere one piece. And then I put glue on the opposite corner and adhere another of those lace pieces that we just made. Okay, so now you have two, and I do that so I can make sure they're evenly spaced apart. And here's the third piece. And then your final piece. And there you have the base of your flower. Now you can see from this one it is, you know, a pretty large flower because we used larger pieces of lace. If you want a smaller flower, you just use smaller squares of lace. So you can really make this any size that you want. I am going to show you the second layer. It's done exactly the same way. I just basically cut the pieces of lace and I'm going to cut them kind of the same size. I'm going to use the same size lace, but I'm going to cut them a little thinner just because I know I want the top layer to be a little bit smaller. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and speed this up. That way you can see the process. Okay, so I went ahead and did the same thing with the second layer. If you noticed when it was speeding through it, I did just move them closer into the center. Instead of starting the corner in the very center, I moved it over a bit so that you could see the pink poking through the back. Of course, I could have used a smaller lace, but that works just as well. So the last part of this, now in this flower you can see I added some more pink in the middle. That was just a step that I did because I had some extra little pink pieces laying around, but I'm not going to do that for this part. What I am going to do is go ahead and just add the center. And how I made the center, because I didn't want, it just seems too big to put the whole thing in there. So what I did was I cut basically the part that I wanted, which is that outer ruffle. I cut that away from the center. And I saved the centers. I don't know what I'm going to use them for, but save them for something. So anyway, I'll put the center aside and then let me see if I can move the lighting a little. And then what I did to form the middle was I just basically twirled it around the center. So I start by just kind of twirling in my hands and then pressing it down on the dab of hot glue that's already there. And then I put some hot glue around the edge and just kind of twist it. I mean, this is all the steps to this flower, just really simple, really quick. And it ends up looking really nice in the end. At least I think it does. Okay. And so I just kind of squish it around the middle. And yeah, I could have just put the whole flower in there, but I just wanted a smaller version of it and I wanted all the ruffles. Now you could just leave it like that if you like that ruffled look. You know, for some of the flowers that I make, I probably will do that. But I just like the way a centerpiece looks in them, so I normally do put a center. So for this one, I had a curl out and now I don't know what happened to it, so you didn't have to hear me crinkling, sorry. For this one, I think I'm just going to do a pearl. I like the bling in the middle, but a lot of times I just like that classic pearl look too. So I just put a little glue and just kind of shove it down so it looks like it's part of the flower. Poor flower. Alright, so we have that, and the last step is just adding our little tails. So now there may be a different way. I don't know, Juliana, if you want to comment on how you do this, but I just kind of lift up some layers of lace and just kind of shove the pearls in there if you want to get technical. But I just do that. I put some glue. I just put a big dab of glue. I'm just folding over the lace trim and just kind of putting it in there. And I just let it sit for a minute so it dries. And I'm gonna do the same thing with the next one. So again, I'm gonna kind of open it up and then just put a big dab of glue. I'm gonna fold my pearl trim, just kind of shove the pearls in there, and then fold it like a little sandwich. I'll give it a couple minutes to, well, a couple seconds to dry because it's hot glue. So that's the pearls. And then for the lace, you could do it the same way, but because normally my pieces of lace are a lot longer and they're not as bulky, I just glue them to the back. That's why I didn't glue the pearls to the back, because you could just glue anything you want to the back, but I didn't want it to be too bulky when I'm gluing it down onto my project. So for the pearls, I put them under one of the flower layers, but for the lace, you can just kind of fold it and just glue it on the back here. And in fact, while that glue is still hot, I'll just put the other piece. And I did the same thing. I folded it just like the pearls, and then I got the middle of it, and that's just kind of what I'm putting down. And I'll space those out a little bit more. And then just kind of wait for that to dry. This glue is like extra hot tonight. I don't know if I plugged it in too long or... My hands are sensitive because I've been using hot glue all day, but it's like burning the crap out of my fingers. All right, there we go. All right, so now that I have little pieces of glue and fabric everywhere, there's the flower. So it's pretty simple to put together. If you're not talking your way through it, it probably goes pretty fast. You know, like I said, you can make them any size. You can make them smaller just by making smaller pieces of fabric. You can make them larger by using larger pieces of fabric, and you can certainly layer. And this is a great way to use up, you know, just little pieces of lace that you have lying around, or if you do ever come across, you know, an estate sale, or, you know, if you go to auctions or anything, a lot of times in auctions, there's always little odds and ends and, you know, little pieces. So this is a great way to use up some of your stash. Thank you so much, Juliana, for the idea. I totally stole the idea from you. And I don't know if this is how you make them, but you know, feel free to comment and share any advice. And thank you everyone so much for watching, and I hope that this was helpful to you. Have a great night. Bye.